Hello, everyone. Welcome to GoTerran TV. I'm Terran, the traveling trainer with GoTerran Personal Training here in the greater Atlanta area. About to welcome back one of my favorite guests right here on today's show, who's also in Atlanta, Georgia, Ms. Susan Longley, a Finish with a Flourish. Now, before Susan rejoins us back on today's show, I'd like to ask everyone out there, if you please be so kind as to like this video, leave us a comment, and share it with all of your friends and family out there. Now, today, I have invited Susan back onto GoTerran TV. It'll be our very first episode together for the new year, and I'm going to check in with her and see how her 2019 treated her, how her 2020 is projected, and we're also going to check in on her injury and see how she's feeling. She's going to talk a little bit about Pilates and some of the new exciting programs that she's going to be offering at the Family Life Center, and you can hook up with her, and she's going to tell you all about that on today's episode. It's going to be a great 30 minutes to check in with Susan and see how she's doing. So we'll have her on here momentarily. And remember that GoTerran Personal Training is your time, your investment, your life. All right, welcome back, everyone. As I promised, side by side, we're welcoming back for the very first time this year, once again, Ms. Susan Longley right here on GoTerran TV. Susan, how are you doing out there today?
I'm great. Happy New Year, Terran.
Yes, Happy New Year to you as well. This is our first one for the new year, and as I mentioned before recording, you're absolutely my favorite guest to have on here, and that's why I love doing these with you. So this is terrific. Thanks so much for your time being able to do this with us.
Sure.
And as I can see in the background, I know that you and I just saw each other off camera literally just a few minutes ago. You must be still at the Family Life Center, it looks like. I could tell.
I am, but I think I'm going to turn around and get that light out from behind my head.
Oh, okay.
Because it looks like I have a halo and I don't.
No, you're fine. And you must be in that side room over there past the restrooms in the atrium.
Yeah, the bridge room.
Oh, okay, cool. No, that's great. I didn't even think about that. That would have been a good place to record, but the lighting in there is really good. Yeah, I could see you just fine.
Yeah, okay, good.
Yeah, this is great, Susan. Well, since I spoke with you last time, you and I recorded an in-person video to help with the website, and I know
Yes, I really appreciated that.
Yeah, that was great. That was a lot of fun.
That really, really good.
I thought so too. And how's that been going since I spoke with you, the website and getting that all together?
We're going to launch the website in a couple of weeks.
Perfect.
I got to get a couple of more interviews together, but coming along.
It is. And since I saw you too just a few minutes ago, Susan, I know that we were talking about your successful recovery from injury as well.
And,
how has that been? And all, you know, just, there you go. People can see it. Because last time you and I did this interview together, you did not have that injury. That happened shortly thereafter.
I did not.
Yes.
Yeah, I tripped over a dog bed over at my sister's house. It's like one of those round beds that have the heavy border.
Right.
And I got my toe caught under that heavy border, and I couldn't get it out, so I just went down. Landed, put my hand out to break my fall, and it did.
Oh, gosh. You know, thank goodness, though, it could have been so much worse. Could have broken a nose, a tooth, broken an
orbital. Could have hit my head. Could have there. Technical difficulties.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So we are back. Right when I lost you there, Susan, if it does that again, I'll just call you back. Guess we could try to take off from there. I don't know what part, but I'll just trim it and splice it in there. So I was just asking you about injuries and the importance of you know, rehabilitation and people, if they get injured, to, you know, all the more importance to exercise and work out. So that was kind of my question there before it cut through.
Yeah. Well, one of the things I liked about it, I did have surgery. They did put a plate in there.
Okay.
And so I have a cast that's removable. I can actually take it off. And that's been good because I've been able to go ahead and start my therapy. I take the cast off, do my exercises, and then put it back on.
Good.
So instead of having it immobilized for 8 weeks and get totally stiff, at least I'm being able to move it a little bit.
Oh, that's great.
I just think what I'd say to anybody that has an injury, get into therapy and start moving as soon as possible. Just really, that's really key to getting a good recovery, is to get that movement going again.
Oh, you're so right. And, you know, it's just like several of your clients, in fact, you help from injury rehabilitation, right? I mean, so you could speak to that. And I know all the physical therapists.
A lot of knee joint replacements.
Right.
They get them up in the hospital like the day of the surgery. You know, you have to start moving that joint.
Absolutely. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, and I can attest to that myself from injuries. So have you seen the influx too, Susan, of all the, quote, New Year's resolution people coming in as well to the gym?
I'm sorry, you broke up on that.
Oh, okay. Are you seeing all the new people come back since it's the new year?
Yeah, I was waiting there the other morning, and four people joined just while I was there for like 45 minutes.
Oh, wow, really?
Like everybody's coming. It's so cute. It's like I said, it must be January.
Oh, that's amazing. And, wow.
And we had 14 people in my water class this morning, so it's,
oh my God.
It's definitely January. That's what I said when I walked into the class. I said, it's January. Everybody's back at the gym.
Wow.
So I hope they'll stay, though.
Yeah, definitely. That's really interesting. I didn't know that happened over at Second Ponce because, honestly, my schedule hasn't changed much. I haven't really gotten anybody new. But are you going to, like, for example, how much longer do you foresee having 14 people in your class there at the water aerobics?
Taryn, you're just breaking up and I can't make out.
I'm sorry about that. Yeah.
I can't make out your conversation at all.
Okay. Let me try it again. How long do people stick with these good intentions of continuing their workouts?
Oh, they'll be gone by March usually.
That's usually what I hear as well, too.
Yeah.
Now, Susan, did you
use... But there are people that do get started. You know, they do use New Year's resolutions as a way of getting started. And,
oh, yeah.
And sometimes it's a slow process.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I have a client right now that's 90, and she just kept coming to our sessions, but she wouldn't do anything at home.
Oh,
and she kept coming back and saying, you know I should be doing something at home, but I'm not doing it.
Right.
But she kept coming. And finally, she did start doing some stuff at home. It's like it just took her a while to get, you know, to get the ball rolling, I guess. And so now she's coming on a regular basis and doing some exercises at home, and she feels so much better.
Oh, that's really good. Tremendous.
So not everybody that comes will leave. So, you know, we'll get some people, we'll get some true believers out of them. So
what would your...
Some of these people that show up in January.
Yeah, January, it always, like you said, and the whole joke is it'll get back to normal in a couple of months. But what would you say to the people to keep them motivated, to keep them consistent and keep coming back in?
Just don't give up.
Yeah.
And if this is your second or third or fourth or 10th resolution, if this is the not just the first year that you've made a resolution to get back to the gym,
mm-hmm.
then just realize that, you know, that every time you start back could be the time that you really stick with it.
Yeah.
And but what it takes is sticking with it. You can't come in and out. And I wish, you know, I could say that it worked that way, but it doesn't work that way. You've got to be consistent with it. And that's just the way the body works.
Yeah, you're right. No question. You also see a lot of people that come in full born, like, okay, I haven't worked out in 5 years, but this is going to be the year. I'm going to overkill it. I'm going to come every single day, 7 days a week. I'm going to do 2 hours every day. And then, you know, the fear is that they're going to get burned out. You know, is that kind of counterproductive to them too?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Even if you haven't been working out, you need to move into it slowly.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, take your time and build a program, build a set of exercises that you can do.
Exactly.
And then just stick with it and not be in a hurry. If you're in a hurry, and then you're also likely to get an injury.
Mm, good point.
You know, overuse injury or just a carelessness injury. And then you're back at square one. Then you're back before square one.
Yeah, right.
Then you have to wait to recover before you can get back into the gym. So it's not a good idea.
I like what you said. Yeah. No, you're right. It's almost like kind of baby steps, right? They should kind of just, like you said, your words, ease into it. I think that's really smart just to get them back into it. But I can't believe, 14 participants in the aerobics water class. Were any of them men or were they all women?
No, they're men.
There were men
not
too.
Not very many, but there are, there's a couple that comes on a regular basis. And then we have guys that come.
Oh, good.
Actually, there was a guy that was here last week that didn't come this week, but it was his first time, and he said, "Boy, this is harder than I thought."
Oh yeah.
He said it looks easy. You know, you're just jumping around in the water, but that's not what you're just doing. If you're doing it right, you're doing some serious core work while you're in the water.
No
so
question.
It's a great way to do core work because you've got all the currents of the water that are pushing you all over the place. So you've got to stabilize your body in addition to doing whatever exercises you're doing.
And the buoyancy too, I guess that helps with the joints and
Right. Yeah, that takes a lot of pressure. People say when they get in the water, as they walk in the water, especially people that are overweight, when they walk in the water, that they just feel so nice. You know, just so you kind of let everything go and you walk in the water and you're buoyant. So you can do some exercises that you wouldn't be able to do if you were out of the water. So that's one thing that I like to encourage people to do, is to start off in the water if they have any kind of issues with using machines or working out on land, is start in the water.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And also, Susan, we always see this with people that are getting kind of intimidated when they come into a gym, that they kind of, let's say, haven't been in there a while or even never been in, much less, and they're just really nervous and they get scared off. What are some of the kind of, you know, advice you can give on avoiding those kind of pitfalls and being too overwhelmed and intimidated?
Again, it just comes back to being willing to, I guess, acknowledge that you're committing to a change of lifestyle, and that it's going to take some time, and that you're going to do some backsliding, and that you're going to be patient with yourself about that, and that it's going to, you're also going to have to look at what I teach is body awareness a lot, is how to become aware of how you're standing, how you're sitting, how you're holding your shoulders, you know, how your muscles are working. And that doesn't come, I can't just tell you that and have you say, oh, I can tell. You know, you have to work with it. And so that's something that develops over time. And you develop more strength as you maintain, as you learn to maintain proper posture. You get stronger. And actually, I had somebody today, they asked me what was the best thing to do for lower back pain. And
good
I was
question.
In the middle with working with a client, so I really couldn't give them a very long answer. So I basically said, maintain proper posture while you do any exercise.
Oh, I like
because
that.
Because I had noticed him earlier doing some arm weights, and he was leaning forward and doing the arm weights while he was leaning forward. And just, I mean, that's a recipe for back pain.
Yeah.
You know?
That might have been the best advice you could have given him. That was good.
So, and he said, really? He said, like, he was surprised at that answer, and it was kind of like he was thinking about it. So I thought, well, maybe it made an impact. So,
I think it will, absolutely. Yeah. That might have been the most important thing you could have told him because, for example, I may have shared with you, Susan, but I've had lower back pain for a long time. And I did physical therapy this year for a great amount of time. And long story short, one of the biggest things that they helped me with was my posture. Like for my car, in fact, because I do a lot of driving, they made me buy one of those lower lumbar pillows. And even sitting here at my desk, too, I'm used to just kind of sitting like this, like hunched over. Or in my car, like this. I'm usually like that. Or watching TV. And they said you cannot do that. They call it the C shape. Like, well, like I used to, like I like to watch and sit like that. But when you sit like that with your posture or stand, like, you know, using your core, if you're tightening your core, that'll force you to be in good posture. They told me the posture was like the number one underlying thing before anything else. And that was probably the best thing you could have told that guy, I'm sure, with the way you observed him doing his routine. So that's really smart. I'm glad you were able to help him out. That's excellent.
And the funny thing was that I had said to my client kind of under my breath is that I really would like to go over there and correct his posture.
Oh,
you know,
wow.
It's not my client, so, you know, I need to keep my mouth shut. But it was funny. I had really noticed it and was just thinking while I was watching him work out that he could be getting so much. I mean, that he was actually probably doing damage
actually,
by exercising in that rolled over position.
It's funny, you know, you mentioned that as well, too, because I was thinking there was a couple of different times. We see it all the time. There's a great debate, trainers saying, are you supposed to ever go up and correct people when they're just doing something with bad form? And I'm always on the fence myself, too. I'm like, well, you know, you see those people doing those over-exaggerated tricep extensions or the bicep curls where they're swinging themselves like that or
using
whatever.
Momentum. You know, building a lot of momentum.
Right.
Not muscle, but momentum. Right?
Yeah. There's you may see this guy. I'll point him out next time. But this guy, he was bragging because he does like 500 crunches every day.
Yeah.
And when I watched him, you may have seen him. You know who I'm talking about. But he lies on the floor. Say I'm on the floor right now. When he's like this, his crunches are like this.
Oh,
he's just
God.
Doing his, and so, in other words, he does 500 neck crunches. He wasn't bringing his shoulders up off the floor at all. His shoulders.
Are you kidding?
If this is the floor, he was like this. He was like. Oh, and he counted to 500 to say, I do 500 of those every day. I didn't have the heart to tell. I just told him, I was like, very good. I just don't know what to say. That's.
I don't know. If somebody asked me, I would probably stick my neck out.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, I hesitate to walk up to somebody that hasn't even said hello to me. and correct them. But right. if somebody asked me, I think I would give them a piece of my mind.
Well, the other funny thing, Susan, there's another guy at that gym, and you know the very first machine when you walk in that one room where they have the dip chin assist with the weights?
Yes,
and
right.
The people that don't know what we're talking about, and basically it's like a fulcrum, so you put as much weight, the heavier the weight, the easier the exercise, not vice versa, the lighter the weight, the harder it is. Well, this guy was in there, and he put it all the way at the bottom of the stack, the heaviest. And he got on there, and he started doing them. And I was like, you know, he's probably like 80-some years old. And he's like, I'm doing it on the hardest weight right now. And I was like, you mean the heaviest weight? He's like, yeah, this is the hardest weight. He said, I've got it all the way down there. He's like, I bet no one else could do this. And he was like doing like 10 or 15 of them. And I didn't have the heart to say anything either. Because
I don't think I would say.
Yeah, exactly. Because it was just, I had to think about that. I was like, wait, he thinks he's doing the heavy, like
the heavy.
Right, exactly. So people out there know what we're talking about probably. But and the other way too, you see people who get, and not only older people, let's say younger people just getting set in their ways, especially guys. I mean, I hate to pick up on men, but women are smarter. I'll admit that. But men, for the most part, will just say, it's my way. I'm doing it right. I don't like to be told that I'm doing anything wrong.
Right.
And so I think women, maybe I'm generalizing, but I think women would probably be more approachable to say, hey, let me show you a different way to do this exercise.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. And that's probably just the nature of it. I mean, that's fine.
But I got in an argument with one of the guys over there that, you know, was doing, you know, doing very fast. Like he was doing the leg extension. And he was like just slamming it up. He had a heavy weight and he was slamming it up and slamming it down.
Oh, no.
And I was saying, you know, I knew him. So I said something to him like, you can do this more effectively if you slow down a little bit.
Right, exactly.
Bring it under control. And he was like, nope, this is the way my football coach. He was like older. This is the way my football coach taught me back in the 30s.
Back in the 30s.
So this is the way I'm going to do it. So it's like, okay.
Oh, my goodness.
So I don't argue with everybody. A lot of people do have their own systems, you know, and that's the way they've always been doing it. But that's one good reason to hire a trainer, isn't it, Terry?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Is to learn something about how to do stuff more effectively. Like, what if you can get more out of your exercise routine?
Definitely.
And what if there's something that's been learned since the 30s?
Oh, that's too funny. Oh, yeah. You know, we all had probably that meathead PE teacher. I had a horrible wrestling coach in high school, and he'd make us put the garbage bags over ourselves and go in the sauna and go run out in this blazing heat. Wouldn't let us have any water. He said, "I'm not." He said, "Water's for wussies." Yeah. He's like, "You guys aren't wussies. Not under my watch. You guys are." And it was just ridiculous. And he was even telling us, like, I want you to go buy some creatine monohydrate and also buy some androstenedione while you're at it and start taking this because you need to bulk up. And there are so many things. Yeah, and this is back, not in the 30s, but this is more in the 90s. But it's just like the things that they would do now, they would just be in big trouble, you know, today, obviously. Yeah. The good thing is we've been more educated and we've corrected that. But
we have learned something.
Yeah, I mean, gosh, it's just unbelievable. If anything, Susan, like for myself, I'm more on the opposite. I like to err on the side of being overly cautious. And all my clients will tell me that. I'll tell them, I'll be like, hey, I'd rather you just do really, really lightweight. And then from there, let's go. Instead of doing the heaviest and scaling it back. I mean, that's just but that guy doing it too fast. We see that a lot, especially at that gym. You're right. We do see a lot of people doing those real quick exercises. And, you know, I guess I got to give them credit for at least being in there. That's good. I mean, at least they're there. It's better than nothing. So
it is better than nothing.
Yeah.
That's what I say. But there are people in my water aerobics class that are literally just jumping around in the water. But I'd rather see them jumping around in the water than be lying on the couch. Right?
Oh, no question. Yeah. I mean, I think that's great. You know, the people that we regularly see that come in and we might see them on a machine and just sitting there for 5 minutes reading a book. At least, like you said, that is definitely better than being on the couch
eating
potato chips.
Definitely better than not doing it. Right?
Exactly. Right. No, I totally agree with you. Yeah. And that's a good testament for all of us to be like, but it's all about movement. It's just moving and just doesn't matter. Exactly. Like if you're moving slow or fast, just get moving. But Susan, how's this been so far this year? You know, I guess let me back up. How was 2019 overall in summary for you? How did you finish? And how's 2020 looking this year? I guess it's a two-part question for you, for yourself.
Well, 2019 was when I first started introducing Pilates into my workout.
Right, exactly.
And I really started doing Pilates myself back the year before that.
Yep.
And then I was getting such fantastic results from it that I wanted to bring it into my clients.
Good idea.
And I see myself doing more and more of that, teaching Pilates more, because especially with my clientele, with people over 60, mm-hmm. it's most of the movements. I mean, you can get into some crazy movements as you can in any exercise, but the basic Pilates movements are small and they're safe, and they just train your core in a way that that nothing else does.
Mm-hmm.
It's mm-hmm. If you look at how a ballet dancer moves,
mm-hmm.
I don't know if people know that or if you ever noticed, but I can always tell a dancer, you know, somebody, if I just see somebody walking around in a store or something, you know, I can tell whether they're a dancer because of the way they carry
posture.
Themselves.
Yeah. Okay. It's that, what do they call that? Where the like head is just like pulled up
yes.
from the string. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You're right.
But more than that, what they do is they have total control over their core.
Yep.
Okay, mm-hmm. So if they're going to move their arm, they're not going to do that. Okay, I don't know if you can see
yeah.
me there, but
I know what you mean.
But,
yeah.
But they're going to maintain stability in their core, and
right.
then they're going to move their limbs from there. So the movement actually comes from the core.
Yeah, exactly.
So,
right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's great for stability. It's great for balance. And the way you get that is by doing very small, control targeted movements mm-hmm. where your goal is to maintain control of your core.
Mm-hmm.
And it may look like in Pilates that you're doing a little exercise where you're just, you know, moving your foot around or you're, you know, in a circle, and it doesn't look like very much. But mm-hmm. the foundation of that is that while you're moving that foot around in a circle,
mm-hmm.
you are keeping your core completely still.
Mm-hmm.
So you're only allowing that leg to move within the hip socket.
Good point.
You're not lifting, you're letting your hips lift up. You're not letting your pelvis lift up. You're not letting anything happen in your back, which gives you an incredible amount of core and back strength that you can't get any other way. And you end up with that kind of dancer's posture and that complete control over your core.
Yeah, that's true. You're right. They definitely have the best control over their core and best posture.
Yep.
Their shoulder blades are back. Their chest is up. You could just tell.
Right.
You're right.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you know, the opposite to that we see as people age usually. I mentioned earlier that C-shape. You usually see
right.
guys hunched over. I mean, their neck's forward. They got that kyphosis going on. And sometimes,
yep.
you know, they've got the overarching chest and overstretched back. They're just not in good alignment. So I think that's really important. I think you're right. Pilates is terrific. Because that really is core centric,
right? Absolutely.
Yeah. No, that's
so
great.
That's what I'm looking for this year is to expand into doing mostly Pilates or Pilates based kind of exercises. Body. I use very few machines, and I use body weight, kind of core strengthening, balance enhancing exercises.
Yeah.
Because that's what my clients need.
I mean,
that's what
everybody
needs to, but especially people that are over 60. So.
Oh, no question. Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah. What, Susan, a mutual friend of ours, Kathy, and Randy, they like to do the Qigong, and it's similar to Tai Chi. What's your thoughts on movements like Tai Chi? Like my parents, for example, they're really into Tai Chi. They won't miss a day without it. Do you watch that, or what's your impression of that kind of those movements?
I think they're excellent because again, they require core control.
Yeah, exactly. Right.
So I think they're excellent. I've never really done them.
Me too. I haven't yet either.
I've done yoga. And I enjoy yoga, but I did one Tai Chi class one time, and I just decided that there was just too much that I didn't know.
Okay, okay.
And no, it was going to take me too long to learn how to do that. So,
yeah.
So I just kind of opted for my yoga and Pilates. And, but I think it's excellent. I do think it's excellent.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. You see sometimes people in the park practicing it as well, too, like where they're doing those slow, methodical, deliberate movements.
Yeah.
And my parents, they just go on YouTube every day and just hit play, and it's the same video.
Really?
And, they're hooked. They're addicted to it. So.
Well, it's a pretty structured routine.
Right.
I know Tai Chi is. There's certain moves that you do in a certain order.
Yeah, exactly.
That's it. So, but I don't know that, so.
Yeah,
but I think it is good.
Yeah, no question about it. And how about, Susan, for your business for this year, goals, not necessarily resolutions for yourself, but long-term range thinking goals, like what else is going on for 2020 for yourself?
really pretty much it's building that Pilates practice and building my website.
Yep.
I want to start talking to people online about fitness, kind of like you do on your videos.
Oh, I love it. Yeah, yeah. It's so much fun.
I want to start doing interviews and just get a I've got a Facebook page that I want to get revved up.
Okay.
Get people talking to me and to each other about fitness over 60 and what it looks like. Like the name of my company is Finish with a Flourish, and my program is Finish with a Flourish. So it's like kind of getting a conversation going about what it means to finish with a flourish. Mm-hmm. And what I always say is that you really can't do that if you're not fit.
Yeah.
If you don't have that physical foundation, if you don't feel good or if you don't feel good enough to be able to, you know, you may not feel great every day, but if you feel well enough and strong enough to get into doing something for yourself that would be a flourish for you, then that's what I'm looking to talk to people about. So so look for finishwithaflourish.com, and in the next couple of give me a couple of weeks, and then we'll have some interviews up, and I'd love to have people. If you've got something to say, or if you want me to interview you, if you've got people that you think, like you said today, was it
Craig?
Craig,
he would be perfect. Yeah, absolutely,
he'd be a good person for me to interview. I've got a guy that that I'm going to interview that's in Florida right now. I knew him when he lived in Atlanta, and he's moved to Florida.
Oh,
but we're going to do like a Skype interview. He's been exercising forever.
Oh, cool.
And he really wants to talk to, and he's in his 60s, and he really wants to talk to people that are in their 60s and say how important it is.
Mm-hmm.
And you're not going to do any flourishing if you're in pain or if you're weak.
Mm-hmm.
So, so let's take care of the physical.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Susan. Well, this is great. Again, I really appreciate, can't wait to interview you again and, kind of cover next month, how the website's going and kind of plugging that as well.
Great.
But, what can we plug in the meantime for people to get a hold of you and contact you directly as well too, Susan?
Okay. My current website is SusanLongley.com.
Okay.
And, you can contact me there. Just, you know, shoot me a message, and I'm at the Family Life Center. And along with Taryn. So love to see anybody come out and get started or get started again.
You're right. That's what it's all about. Very well said. Absolutely, Susan. Well, keep doing the amazing work, and best wishes to you.
Thank you, Taryn.
Thank you. And I appreciate your time today too, Susan. And enjoy this great year, and my best wishes for another successful year for you.
Great. Thank you, Taryn.
All right. Thank you, Susan. And here comes your contact info right now. We'll see you, Susan.
Thank you. Okay.
Bye-bye. Bye.